In this video, we are going to see how to use Google Earth Engine in QGIS. To be able to use Google Earth Engine in QGIS, we need to install a plugin called Google Earth Engine. For that, go to Plugins menu and click on Manage and Install Plugins. And from the QGIS plugins repository, search for Google Earth. And you will see the Google Earth Engine. Click on this and install plugin. And it says plugin installed successfully. Now let's close this. Now under the plugins, you will see Google Earth Engine. And first we need to sign in. Click on sign in button. It will take you to the browser for login. Click on your Gmail account with which you opened your Google Earth Engine. Click on allow button. And you will see a message called Google Earth Engine authorization successful. Credentials have been retrieved. Now let's close and go to QGIS. It will ask you to select Earth Engine project. Since you can have multiple projects in your Google Earth Engine account, so you need to write the project name here. If you do not know what projects you are working, you can go to your Google Earth Engine account. Go to the code editor and in the right side you will see your project name. And also you can click on this account button and select the project info. Here you can see your cloud project. Let's copy the project from here and click done. Now go to the QGIS again and paste the name of your cloud project and click okay. Now our Google Earth Engine account is connected to our QGIS plugin. Now let's see how to use the plugin. We will add an image from Google Earth Engine to QGIS. For that we can use this menu from plugin menu, or we can go to processing and select toolbox. Under the toolbox, we will see one menu called Google Earth Engine. This is the same menu which we will see in plugins menu. We can use this from any menu. Let's add an image first. Click the Add Image toolbox. And here we need to write the image ID. Here is a sample image ID. Let's write this. It will add a digital elevation model. Let's write it. SRTM GL1_003. And we need to write the extent here. Let's use the extent of our map, currently visible map. Let's click on map canvas extent. And this image has only one band. So we can select same band in all RGB. Or if you want, you can leave it blank. And also from color ramp, we can select color ramp and let's run the processing. You will see the message. It says algorithm failed, Earth Engine error, image visualize cannot provide a palette when visualizing more than one band. So since we are using multiple bands, it cannot be processed. Let's turn off all and run again. Now we can see that the image is added. Let's close this and bring it up. It will take some time to be visible since it is coming from the Google Earth Engine server. Let's zoom to layer. And since the visualization is not very good, we can change the visualization using properties and symbology. Since this is a tiled layer coming from server, we cannot change the symbology directly here. So let's save the data first. For that, we need to go to export. Under Google Earth Engine, you will find a menu called export and click on export image to GeoTIFF. Now the scale of SRTM dam is 30 meter. Let's make it 30, and we can save the extent from the whole image, and let's export the band to the right side. So this band, or if you have multiple bands, the selected bands will be downloaded, and this is the location where your GeoTIFF will be downloaded. Click on browse, go to the folder you want to save the file. Let's write the name as dim and save. Now let's run the code. It will take some time since it is being downloaded from the server to our local computer. The file is downloaded. Now it is being merged. Since there are 8 tiles, all will be merged together to make one image. Here we can see that the export is completed. Now let's close this and go to browser and expand the folder where you have saved your image, GeoTIFF. Now drag it to our project. Now we can remove the tiled layer. Remove layer and okay. This is the downloaded file that we have downloaded from Google Earth Engine, the DIM, SRTM Digital Innovation Model. Let's go to properties and change the symbology to single band pseudo color and then equal interval apply. Let's invert the colors. Or we can also select the turbo. Let's click OK. Here we can see the bluish part is showing lower elevation and the reddish part is showing higher elevations. In our future videos, we will see multiple use of these tools, how we can download, export and do a lot of analysis task in QGIS using Google Earth Engine. Thanks for watching.